A cage of cold metal with hot rubber at the corners. A chariot of thundering fury. The difference between you and your rivals isn't just the war paint traded in battle. It's more. Refuse to lose.
And welcome, folks. This is Mr. Wilson 25. Might seem a little weird that I just watched all the way through that intro, but I like it, and I feel like if I can't start the stream before booting up the game, why not just include that as the official kickoff of the video? Just what I figured. Up next, we go to Auto Club, beginning with the Xfinity Series, and I've decided I will run 6 dirt races this season instead of just the 5 at the end because I want to have a shot at the championship, which entails winning a race. But after that, I should be running a good enough program that we should be able to lock a spot in the playoffs and then go through all that to hopefully win the championship. But the Xfinity Series is not off to a particularly great start, but I'm not going to intervene just yet. We don't actually have, or we're not actually racing all that soon. That's our first race. Charlotte, so let's see what that is. That'll be the Kansas weekend for the Cup Series. So not exactly something to look forward to. And let's see. That'll be the second Michigan Cup race. That'll be the the feeder to the Watkins Glen Cup race. And then this will be the feeder to the Charlotte Roval Cup race. And that's all we're doing in the Xfinity Series this season. The only races we're running. Wilson runs a high school program to put students in. That's who's driving for him during these races that he doesn't participate in. And when I ran this race last season, or the season before, I got as far as 6 seconds out front. How is that possible? I wonder if it is just going off your qualifying position from the last time. If so, this is going to be a terrible season for the Xfinity program. But! Enough on that subject, we head over to the Cup Series and our endeavor here. Let's see, 97 to 74. That's not a huge lead, but it's something. And he's got more stage points than I do, actually, so that's another thing to be worried about. But we're the only ones that have wins this season. And if only it could stay this close throughout the season towards the end. Joey Gase is 1 point back. He helped me win the Daytona 500, actually. Michael McDowell's 2, Johnson 4, Reagan 7, Carter 7. And that's as far back as I can see. So yeah, the dirt race will be happening pretty soon either today or tomorrow. But we're not going to worry about the dirt tour too much because that is not on deck. What is on deck is the NASCAR Cup race at Auto Club. Yeah, one thing to note is I am probably one reason finished 21st. I am a weak qualifier. Like, I have one top five qualifying position in the Cup Series, which was third in Miami. Which was a race that we went on to go dominate. We didn't lead every lap, but we dominated. There was a section where it was always too loose, but it was probably okay, just a glitch in the track and something that I'm just going to have to be careful about, but there's no way we can set up for it. There's no way we can create a setup accounting for it.
Careful, still there. Clear all around.
And then out here, it's nice and wide open. A lot of room for error. A lot of places to make a mistake, too. That's not encouraging. No, that is. Because remember, we won this race last season. It wasn't easy, but we did win. All I can really think to do for qualifying is to just make it as loose as possible, make it as fast as possible. Which might seem like a good idea for the race, but only until you start drifting out of corners. And when you start drifting, you know you're in trouble. This place could totally be like Daytona or Talladega. It's a shame they're getting rid of this configuration in real life. Yeah, that was pretty bad. And this is not a race setup, this is testing for qualifying. Not sure how this is gonna go. Just getting a little music ads. I don't even know what they're trying to advertise, honestly.
Clear out, hammer down.
I hate that these cars are constantly rolling when they're powered on. Oh, no, 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 no. Ooh.
Hold your line. Got one outside. Car outside.
Maybe that setup will be a problem. Let's just bring it back to the garage.
Okay, get back in there. Let's go.
What happened was I started straddling the blend line in the track. And then... just got loose, tried to correct it, came up the track, got hit by Bobby Carter. Not gonna run this setup during the race because the fall off will be super terrible. The big problem is the brighter the bulb burns, the quicker it burns out.
That was a great lap.
That time my minimum speed while cornering was 173, which is a lot higher than it's been. I mean, this thing will burn out real quickly and it'll become super slow relatively early compared to a tighter setup.
Keep it up. That was your best lap ever.
All right. We're going to take our race setup.
Clear out, hammer down.
We'll do three pit entries, two stops. On the third, we'll just bring it to the garage and be done for practice. I guess we didn't need to do that. And Yeah, it was the Daytona 500 where I read the speedometer as high as it's ever been. At 211 miles an hour. Never did talk about that during practice for Vegas, but yeah, 211. Fastest I've seen in this game, probably fastest possible. Oh, way too early.
You're going too fast. Black flag is in the air. It's for us.
We go too early and then somehow end up going too fast on the way in. How convenient. But it looks like no changes to wedge is needed. No change to air pressure. It really is just sort of a trade-off between speed and fall-off that you have to worry about. Oh, right, we got this 30-second penalty. Yeah, that's not going to happen again. Practically coasted, didn't slow down in time.
Clear out, hammer down. Going too fast.
That was good. That was acceptable. We just got to do one more of those and then I'll feel ready. Yeah, we are all ready. Gonna swing it back around, bring it in, and then take it to the garage.
Clear of the pits, hammer down.
Oh, I got distracted there. Straddling the apron and the track, that is dangerous. Swinging around. Oh. I promise, I don't think I'm dying of COVID. As it made its way to me, it's not unlikely. It's not unlikely it makes its way to all of us. No, but I am coughing. That's for certain. Going to adjust it, loosen it up, and see if we could get a good qualifying position.
Let's go.
Then we will adjust it back to where we are in the race, or to where we want it for the race. And then I'll take a quick water and bathroom break before getting the race underway. 100 laps around this place. Maybe about an hour.
All right, coming to the green. This one counts.
That was bad.
All right, qualifying's over. Good job.
Oh, almost got it. 12th, though. That's probably one of the better qualifying positions in my career. Let's see how the field stacks up. On the front row are Kurt Busch and Denny Hamlin. Row 2 will be taken up by Alex Bowman and Kyle Busch. Row 3 sees the Penske's of Brad Keselowski and Joey Logano. Row 4 has the Fords of Ryan Newman and Clint Boyer, and rounding out the top 10 are Chase Elliot and Kevin Harvick. We're going to adjust that, and we will be starting 12th because no penalties. We've gained exactly one spot all season from penalties after qualifying. That was in Las Vegas. We actually got a last-to-first win in Daytona by a margin of 0.006 of a second. So that was awesome. But anyway, intermission time. Then it's off to the race.
Check your engine light. dealership, if you buy it on the does, they take
All right, time's up. Let's do this.
Coming to the green, driver. Almost ready. Hammer down, green's out. Looking inside now. Still there. Got one inside. All right, you're clear. Still there. Careful, still there. Clear high, clear high. Stay low, stay low. To the wall. Stay low, stay low. All right, you're clear. low. Careful, still there. Careful, still there. Stay low. All right, you're clear. Got a car low now. Bottom's clear. Careful, still there. Careful, still there. Stay low. Clear high, bud. Got one inside. All right, you're clear. We got 20 more left. Car there on the inside. Still there. Careful, still there. All clear. High lane's clear. Stay high up here. Clear down low. Got a car low now. Still there. Bottom's looking good. All clear. Inside. You're all clear on the bottom. All right, halfway this lap. Still there. All right, clear outside. All clear. The car ahead of you is pitting. Clear all around. I need 10 solid laps. Concentrate. The car ahead of you is pitting. You're almost out of gas. Back it down, back it down. Clear up the pit, hammer down. Car outside, hold your line. Stay low, stay low. All right, you're clear. good. Clear all around. Stay on the bottom here. Clear all around. All clear. Still there. All right, you're clear. Five to go, five to go. Took that stage. Great job. Coming to the green. Are you ready? Careful, still there. All right, you're clear. That's the halfway mark. go. You got this. Still there. All right, clear outside. Still there. All clear. Yellow flag. All right, you're coming to the green. Be ready. Green down, let's go. Stay low. Careful, still there. Still there. Clear all around. Stay low. Clear high, clear high. Still there. Car high, careful. Clear high, clear high. Still there. Stay on the bottom. Careful, still there. All clear. Five to go. Got one inside. Clear low, bud. All right, I need two more good laps from you. Inside. Clear low. White flag next time by. Took that stage. Great job. Going green. Almost ready. Careful, still there. Still there. Clear high, bud. Got one inside. All clear. Got one inside. All clear. Inside. Careful, still there. Still there. Careful, still there. All right, you're clear. Still there. All right, clear outside. Still there. You're all clear up top. You're almost out of gas. You're almost out of gas. All clear. Coming to the green. Be ready here. Careful, still there. Stay on the bottom. All clear. go. Inside. All clear. Got one down low now. All clear. Inside. All clear. Five laps to go. Looking inside now. You're all clear on the bottom. Farther on the inside. Clear down low. two laps to go. White flag, next time by. Fantastic job. Great win.
All right, the highlights will be starting shortly. What a day. Let's be real. There was no one that really could have defeated me there. I started off strong. I had to battle Kyle Busch and Denny Hamlin at the beginning for a little bit. But once I got my stride, Denny Hamlin was the only one in the last 14 laps that was able to challenge me for pretty much anything. I think Clint Bowyer got a run on me once, but pretty much from the moment I gained the lead, never lost it except for pit cycles, in which David Reagan knocked me back to second, and then I fell back to ninth towards the end of stage two when the caution came out then, and then back to third when a caution came out interrupting the pit cycles in stage three. The green flag stops in stage three. I'll tell you what, if I hadn't made Martin Truex Jr. proud, then either his expectations are way too high, or clearly there's something about me he doesn't like. And of course I don't mean the real Martin Truex Jr., because this is a video game on the third highest difficulty, which still at times can feel pretty easy with superior equipment. In stage two, the Gibbs cars were 1, 2, 3, 4, which was kind of cool to see. And listen to that crowd cheer. Now we're gonna go murder the grass a little bit. All right, and then because it's right there, we're gonna take it to victory lane. I mean, come on, it's right here. Why would I not? Yep, that's going to be a custom thumbnail or a Zoom background. The race was fantastic. One of my best runs probably since Bristol won in the Xfinity Series. We got up there. We had to battle a little bit for the lead, but once we got it, we were unstoppable. I gave you a quick summary of the strategy of it. And it really wasn't that eventful of a day. There were some position swaps. I was damaged. I was worried I took a little bit of damage at times. But thankfully, I never did. And we set sail on the leaders. Not sure what happened right there. Oh yeah. It took a little while to pry it from their hands, but I think... yeah, probably around this time I got it and then got it for good. Okay, maybe not. There was a period where I got stuck on the high side. Couldn't move down to get the better line. I felt like it went like this for some time. Notice the first half of the highlights has all happened in 11 laps. Okay, yeah, this is when I get it. Ten laps later. Not sure what happened to cause that wreck. And no, this is not taking the checkered flag for either stage. Someone got a run on me. I think it either was Corey LaJoy or Clint Bowyer who was able to surge. Clint Bowyer. I was able to get a little bit of a surge as I was moving up through traffic. But other than that, I really didn't have any other struggles. Making a pass for the lead. When I was working on him, Denny Hamlin was really fast, but once I got past him, the biggest lead I had at any point was probably like 3-4 seconds. That was when I turned off the wall. And then this. We gotta watch this from a couple of different angles. And that's it. Okay, you know what? Scratch that about watching a couple different angles on that last restart. But that last restart We lined up third behind Denny Hamlin, Chase Elliott, overtook them, and that was the winning move. Denny Hamlin would trail me for a while, but not be able to make anything happen. And after that, we were just sort of able to, after like maybe four laps from the end, he started to fall off, and we were able to cruise to the win. We win the race with a time of 64 minutes and 23.910 seconds, with Denny Hamlin in tow. Ryan Newman finished third, with Kyle Busch in fourth. William Byron took the final spot in the top five, and Joey Logano and Brad Keselowski finished sixth and seventh. Eric Jones was eighth, meaning this is only the second time I've seen all four Gibbs cars up in the top 10, with Austin Dillon ninth and Alex Bowman rounding out the top 10. Look at that, the season is already going in the right direction. Fastest lap, that's not much of a surprise. Most laps led easily. On the move, Austin Dillon. And then who got the tough break? Ryan Preece. Let's see, actually. Just Darrell Wallace Jr. out of the race. So only one DNF. Maybe two, hold on. No, just the one DNF. Alright, so that wraps up NASCAR Cup Series action, and depending on when the dirt race is, I think it will be happening today. I don't know. All I know is it happens between now and Atlanta. Maybe just after Phoenix. But we'll do it because it's like 15 minutes in length, and let's be real, that's not very long. I could turn it up to 100%, it wouldn't even be much more than 20 minutes. Maybe it would. All right, you know what's coming. Three wins in five races. Come on, who am I? Someone off the street? Oh, did you look at that? They actually booted someone. Okay. So yeah, we rush over to Las Vegas and the dirt track, and let's see. Can we win a cup race and a dirt race in the same day? I mean, come on. You know the answer to that question. Do you? Because I don't know. So pretty much the plan is I'm going to start the dirt tour and then not race again until the playoffs and then just run all the races in the playoffs. I mean, depending on how long it is, I might just run the dirt tour full time. Because these races are not long at all. There are 50 laps around a quarter mile track, which at it should only be like 15-20 minutes of race time. And we actually did race it once already, but we get my number back, which is 25. I missed this. Back where it all began. I do kind of miss that sound. Wonder if this is what the car sounded like in NASCAR Heat Evolution. We're not one lap into the dirt season and we're already spinning out. And this is like the only series where I could ever get a pole. No problem. We're gonna take a short break for water, so I can get some water before getting into this race, but we won't spend too long in the intermission because, you know, it's not a long race. It's only 15 laps around this place. 50 laps. I don't know. If it's anything less than 20 minutes, I think we'll just do this full time. I'll do this series full time. All right, that's good. Now, pretty much my one question for everyone here is, did they miss me? I can assure you, no one here missed me. And if you didn't watch any of my dirt tour videos,
all right, coming to the green.
You are about to see why.
All right, that's our run.
Oh,
back her down.
That was like one of our worst laps all day. Ouch. Now I know you're not going to recognize any of the names I'm going to call out. On the front row are Randy Davis and Leslie Gomez. Row 2 will be taken up by Justin Jones and Tony Stewart. Row 3 sees Bobby Carter and Kobe Brock. Row 4 is Caleb Stevenson and Hugh Ackerman. And rounding out the top 10 are Mark Hunter and Eric Wright. Told ya. You're not gonna recognize any of these names, but we are going to, now, it says I have 36 subs. There's no way that's right. I don't know. I'll look into it. I'm not trying to be dishonest. It just says I have 36 subs in my stream UI, but it just doesn't seem right. Anyway, I'm going to go get some water. We will head out to the dirt track.
Possible
If I could put my expectations for my performance in this race into one word, it would be mayhem. Stick around. The Extreme Dirt Tour, next.
Coming to the green. Almost ready. Green's out, let's go. All right, you're clear. Clear low, bud. Got one inside. All clear. All clear. Car outside. All clear. Load clear. Excellent lap. Good job. You got room. You're clear. Are there on your outside? All the way to the wall. Outside, outside. Clear high, bud. Careful, still there. All right, you're clear. Hold your line, got one outside. Five to go. You're all clear up top. You're all clear up top. Car outside. All clear. Got a car high now. Clear high, bud. All clear. Two laps to go. More to go. You took that stage. Great job. Coming to the green. Almost ready. All right, clear outside. That was a great lap. Ten to go. Still there. Clear high. Clear high. All right, you're clear. Car there on your outside. Clear all around. All clear. Five to go. Got a car high now. Clear all around. Got one up top. Clear high, bud. Outside, outside. All clear. Outside, outside. Two laps to go. Clear high, bud. All clear. More to go. You took that stage. Great job. Coming to the green, driver. Be ready here. All right, you're clear. Careful, still there. All clear. Clear high, clear high. Car outside, hold your line. 10 laps to go. Clear high, bud. Are there on your outside. All right, you're clear. Clear high, clear high. All clear. Still there. All clear. All right, clear outside. All clear. And full laps to go. That counts five. All right, you're clear. Car outside. You're all clear up top. Still there. Careful, still there. Two to go. All clear. You got one to go. Stay on the bottom. All clear. Got a car high now. Clear high, bud. Black and white is in the air. That's the checkered flag. Good job.
All right. Just sit tight. The dirt highlights will start. Now, you might be wondering, why did I put the dirt highlights in before the cup lights or the Cup highlights if they didn't go in chronological order? Well, the explanation for that is simply that... the Dirt Tour is the bottom of the promotional ladder, so I just wanted to have the Cup Series go in as sort of like a main event, rather than the Cup Series come first, but then the Dirt highlights come afterwards. I mean, come on, that really makes no sense from an editing standpoint. So, why do it? There's not a whole lot of originality you can do with the burnouts in the Dirt Series. Feels so weird to be on Hoosiers. We've been running Goodyears since, well, since we won the championship in the Dirt Tour. I just ran this first race to win and guarantee a spot in the playoffs. So this is not a long replay, so the Cup Series will come soon. And it really has no reason to be a long replay. We got past Leslie Gomez pretty close to the end of the first stage and led every lap after that. I mean, that is literally it. And I was actually quite surprised how clean my driving was. I ran into the back of someone there, almost got turned by, I could count the number of contact incidents on one hand. Oh no, I forgot there was contact trying to pass her up. And then pretty much just never looked back. We won stage two. And then cruised to an easy win. And that's it. I mean, there's really nothing else to say about that other than, dominated the entire race. We win with a time of 14 minutes and 33.557 seconds with Caleb Stevenson in second. Third was Cody Brock with Eric Wright in fourth. David Ryan climbed the ladder to fifth with Leslie Gomez taking the final spot on the lead lap in sixth. Tony Stewart finished seventh, Bobby Carter eighth. Alan Anderson took ninth, and rounding out the top ten is Randy Davis. It's going to be such a low pay grade. Oh wow. Merch payout 269031. That is insane. Yeah, I'm just going to run the series full time because the races are so short, with the exception of Jefferson. And it was a lot cleaner than I expected. Most laps led, 47, so almost all of them. David Ryan on the move, started all the way at the back. And Hugh Ackerman falling from 7th to 20th. The next dirt race will take place at Drebin. Which will be, I think, after Texas. Because I won this race my season in the Dirt Tour, and I did that and moved up. Oh yeah, that's right. Did that, and then I was called by a truck team. Truck team moved up, ran their race at Texas, went back down to Drebin, impressed a couple of good teams. Nice Motorsport gave me a call, which gave me a full-time season that would culminate in a championship. And we're going to have something to say. Yeah, it's a sign of things to come. And that is not my first win in the series by any means. And in the next video, we're going to be going Phoenix, Miami, Atlanta. We're just going to be running the race at Phoenix in the Cup Series. And then, yeah. My 45th win since moving, in the timeline, which doesn't involve the career before I reset. The guy was on a family trip. He didn't even know he wanted to go into motorsport until a help wanted sign at Monza, Toro Rosso was testing, invited him for a ride, impressed them, got the contract, quit Formula One after a while because it wasn't my taste, and this is all me, not my alter ego, so I'm playing F1 2009 now again, which is my return to Formula One, so I quit at the Nürburgring about halfway through the season, waited a couple of months, came over here, got called by a dirt team, finished 20th, six laps down at Drebin, was able to impress a couple of other teams though, won a dirt race here, and then finally debuted in NASCAR, which I had my sights set on since starting Formula One. Anyway, just to give you a basics of where I came from, this has been Mr. Wilson 25, and I will see you all in the future.